So everybody can see my screen here now. Can you all just confirm me that? So here now in the next example that I'm covering up here, I'll be actually talking about the content provider wherein I'll be using the content provider to query up the contacts of the device. So here if I talk about this device, I go on to the contacts here. It does not have any contacts yet. Alright, so let's create one. So I'll add any random contact here. I'll give a call and then I'll just disconnect and I'll add it to contacts here. Here I'll just end this call and I'll just add this to contacts. I go to create new contact and just give it a name. I say Edureka. I think I just saved a blank contact here. I'll just do it again. I'll just edit this particular contact here and I say Edureka. Alright, and I just done. Alright, so I'll be saving this contact up. Now if I'll be running this content provider here, I'll just show you, it's like I'll be actually accessing four methods here. Alright, so here what I'll be doing is I'll be having methods that I'm actually using up for all the four buttons that I have created here. Whether if I talk about view contacts, if I talk about add a contact, modify or delete. So if I click on view contact, since I have a contact in my phone here, so it shows up that. Alright, so let's go to this example that I have covered up. I had already told you that we need permissions in order to use the content providers here. So you can see I have added two permissions here. The permission to read the contacts and also the permission to write the contacts, because whenever I'll be editing or whenever I'll be creating any contact, I'll be actually needing those permissions. Alright, I hope this is clear to everyone. How we add permissions is clear to everyone. You need to go to permissions, you need to go to add. You need to go to users permission, find the appropriate permission that you want to use up. If I say read or write something onto the content provider here, so you can see here I have the various read permissions here and similarly I have the various write permissions here. Right, so here you can just find your permissions that you're using in your application. So if I go to the manifest here, I have those permissions here. I have the permissions to read the contacts and I have the permissions to write the contacts. I hope this is clear to everyone how you can have the permissions, how you can add permissions in your applications. I'll just go to the sample here. So here I have a native content provider. I have created four buttons as I showed you. So let's see the layout here of the four buttons here. So here I have four buttons: view contact, add contact, modify contact and delete contact. And beneath that what I have done is I've just raised a toast notification. So if I talk about the view one, alright, so here in the view method what I have done is I have created a method which says display contacts. So let's see what this method contains here. So if I go on to display contacts here, what I'm doing is I'm actually creating a content resolver object, because since I told you whenever I'll be using the content provider, I'll be having a client, that is I'll be having a content resolver client. So here I get the content resolver client of this application, create a cursor, because whenever I'll be picking up data from the database, I'll be actually needing a cursor for it. So I create a cursor here. Then what I'm doing is I'm actually having the content URI here. So if I talk about this particular thing, it is actually the database name, or say the location of the database that I have in my device. So here I have the contents URI. What I'm doing is I'm querying this content URI. All the other parameters are null here. So the projection, the selection arguments, any parameters that I want to pass up here are null. You can see there. Alright. So this is the URI, that is the table name, projection. If I want any particular, I would say only the name, only the contact number, I can have those as projections here. Then selection could be like where name equal to say XYZ. So this is the selection is equal to where, and selection arguments are like ABC or XYZ anything. I can also identify the sort order here. So this is how what all the query parameters work here, and I'm passing all the null, all the parameters null, because what I'm needing is I'm actually fetching up all the details from the table name. When I get the cursor here, I say check for the cursor dot get count, that is all, it contains some elements here. I'm just checking for that. Alright, when I just check for the contents here, I take a string object, get the contact, that is the ID. If I'm actually storing something onto the content providers here, so I always store an ID along with it, and I get the name from the display name. That is what is the name that gets to be displayed. And I'm just checking that it has got a phone number. I'm just checking, because sometimes what happens is I can add a blank contact without giving it a telephone number. So I check for that, that whether it contains a phone contact number or not. If it does, alright, then I'm creating another cursor here, and this cursor will be actually querying up the content URI, that is the same method, same table name here, but now we have a parameter here where I say the phone contact ID equal to the ID that I'm passing here. Alright, because I actually want to pick up the phone contact of only that contact that I have with my ID attribute. And I just check that there might be multiple instances of that particular having multiple contact names. As if I say, take an example, it could be the work contact, it could be the home contact, it could be the office contact. So different contact numbers I can have. Alright, there I create a string number, phone number here, get the phone numbers from the contact here, and just raise a toast notification. So this will run an iteration, so the number of contacts that I'll be having, so it will run an iteration. So just to check that, what I'll do here is I'll create another contact here. I'll create another new contact here, and I say Amit. Alright, since I haven't assigned any contact number to it, so this will not show up now, or it will show up a blank contact number. So let's go and edit it up. Go to phone, go to add, and here I can add any random number here. And I click on none, this gets saved. So now if I'll be actually running this application, and I'll be querying the content provider here, I'll be actually seeing two contacts here instead of the one that I saw in the last section, since I have actually modified the content provider here. So I'll just wait for this application to be run up onto the simulator here. There seems to be some problem with the application. Let me just check. What is the error here? The manifest, I think. I actually added up the permissions twice here. So if I click on view contacts here, it will be raising two toast notifications, one of the name Edureka and one of the name Amit. Alright, so this is how it works up. Now I have already told you about how the view contacts works. Now let's also talk about how we can also add a contact. Alright, so in this particular segment, what I'm doing is I'm just having a simple method which will be actually adding contacts to it. Here what I'm passing this method as parameters are a sample name which will act as the name of the contact and a contact number. So if I go on to the create contact here, what I'm doing is I'm again taking the cursor resolver, taking the cursor to the content URI, that is the context URI. I see where cursor.getCount is greater than 0, that is I have some cursor elements here, and I check for the name, because if I have already got a name existing in my application, why should I be actually adding that up? So I'm just keeping a check here, which will be checking for the name here. So I'll be getting the cursor object, I'll be getting the existing name here, and I check, I compare whether this existing name contains name. Right, so I just say that this name is already existing. Then what I do here is I take a content provider operation here. So this is a type of an array list which is very specific to content providers, right? And this array list is actually used for all the insertion operations or the editing operations that I'm taking in the content providers. So here I create an operations, I go on to the content provider, click on new insert, because I'll be adding something onto the content provider now. Take the contents URI here, and here with the value, that is what is the value that I want to add up. So here I'm actually having these table names, so you can think of these things as the field names in the table content provider. Alright, so I'm actually adding up an account type, and I'm adding this value to the account type. Similarly, the account name, I'm adding this value to the account name, and then I'm doing a build. Just remember that whenever I'll be adding up any particular item onto the array list here, that is the content provider array list, I'll be actually having a build here, because it will be actually saving the changes onto the array list. Similarly, I'll be adding up other things like the contact ID, because I'll be adding some ID to the content provider here. The MIME type, that is what is the type of the content, and here also the display name. So this is another operation that I'm adding on to the array list. Similarly, I'm adding a content URI here. This is the table name with the value contact ID equal to 0, MIME type equal to content MIME type, and then I'm adding two values here, the number and the type of the number, that is whether it is of type home. I can have multiple types here. I can have type callback, type car, all the types that are available to me. Right? So here I can have this. So if I say work mobile, that means it is my work mobile contact number. I can have the type of contact here, and I do a build. And then I have to apply a batch, because since I'm making some changes onto the content provider here, all right, then I do a apply batch, then I need the authority to do the apply batch. Because if I as an individual can make any changes onto the content provider, that is not going to serve any purpose. I need to have the authority to make changes. So this authority is actually governed by the context contract, and this authority variable gives me the authority, and I just add this up onto the content provider. So this is what I'm doing here, and I just raise a toast notification, and I say created a new contact with the name. So let's see this running up. So if I click on add a contact, what I'll be adding is, I'll be adding up a sample name along with the number this. Alright, so now this gets added up onto the content provider. Let's view again all the content providers. I have one, I have two, and then I have three, which is the sample name. Right, so let's also talk about how we'll be modifying a content onto the content provider. So when I talk about modification, it is very much similar to the in terms of operation here. But the only difference would be here, I'll be actually using other operators here. So here you can see, I'm actually creating a where clause, because whenever I'll be making some modifications onto the database, I need to know where am I doing the modifications here. Right? So here I say, so I create a where clause here, where I say display name equal to the one that I'm passing here, and the phone number also I'm passing here. And I say display name equal to something, and the MIME type of the contact is equal to the phone type contact, right? And then I say, what are the values that I need to pass in here? I have to pass in the name, because this will act as the first parameter to this question mark. Then I'm passing the MIME type, which will act as this parameter to the question mark, and then I'm passing the contact type home. So this will act as this parameter to the contact here. So if you all remember, I changed the type here. I changed it to mobile phone, office mobile, if I'm right here. So I change this up to work mobile. Alright, so I'll be finding up work mobile now. Then what I do is I just do a managed query on the contents URI, where I have to find out where this parameter matches the parameters that I'm passing. That is where display name equal to sample name, MIME type equal to the type that I'm passing here, and also the phone type equal to work type mobile. Then only it will be returning me the object here. Create another array list of content provider. If I say it does not have anything here, so it will be creating a new contact here. If it has one, so it will be adding up onto the contact, onto the window here, that is operation window, array list, and it has to update the sample name too. Alright, so let's see this by running up. And if I run this up onto the emulator, if I click on modify contact, so the modify contact of sample name to this, that is, it just changes the number. Since it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, now it has got changed to something else, which is 9, 8, 7, 6, any random number here. Similar to all the things here, I also have a delete method here. Alright. So let's talk about the delete method here. In the delete method, what I'm doing is I'm passing in a parameter as name. That is whatever name I want to delete up. Since I'll be deleting only the one that I have created, so I have named it as sample name, so I'll be deleting the sample name here. But if you want, I can also delete my name here. So let me just check what exactly is the name that I have provided here, and I'll just delete mine. I go on to view contacts. It says Edureka. It says Amit. So I'll just remove Amit from this list here. Alright. So I go on to the method delete here. And here I'll just key in my name. So I have keyed my name here. So if I go on to delete contact, I get the content resolver, create a where clause here, where the display name equal to something, and the name is the one that I'm passing here onto the path, onto the method here. Create an array list of content operations, keep on adding, and here I create a new delete, which takes the URI with the selection arguments, that is where name equal to the name that I'm passing, and I do a build, and then I finally apply a batch. So this will be deleting the contact name Amit from the content provider. So if I click on delete here, it says deleted the contact with the name Amit. If I go on to view contacts, now that won't be available to me. I hope this is clear to everyone how all these methods are working up. If you all want to take a look at the example code that I have written here, you can just ask me here onto the chat window, in the case which I'll be actually letting you all have a look at the code here. And if you have, if you're facing any problems in understanding the code, you can ask me up. Any person having any doubts in this particular example that we have covered, you can write it onto the chat window. So does anybody wants to take a look at the example code here, or they'll be taking it a look at themselves when the code will be shared after this class? Jasneet says a lot of work to be done after the class. It is not that typical, Jasneet. To be very honest, this is just the type of normal conventions that we have and that we follow. Whenever we'll be querying the database, we'll be actually using a cursor for it. So nothing different in this cursor operation here. The only difference that I see here is the array list, which is the array list of the type of the content provider. Farhan says, very complex. I told you, Farhan, this is all the advanced topics that we are covering today. We'll be also covering the SQLite database today. So I think everybody should be very much prepared in order to understand the SQLite database. I hope this is clear to everyone. If not, I understand that it might look a little complex to all, but once you start working on this, that is the reason why I want everybody, every single attendee, to work on the project. Because when you'll be working on the projects, you'll be getting some more insight into it. right? That is how, because when you actually will be experiencing these fears, that is wherein you are stuck up somewhere and you want to find out ways, then only you have the zest to learn something new. I hope this is clear to everyone then. Should I take some more time here? Do you want to see the code here or should I proceed ahead? You all can write it onto the chat window if this is clear to everyone. All right.